I want to just review a few things that I've mentioned in other tapes, but they're basic fundamentals and they're very, very important. Okay, we are all aware that a drumstick is tapered at one end, and so the balance point is not in the center of the drumstick, it's to the rear. So we want to hold it actually back further than where it is really, where the balance point would actually be. And in the right hand, it's held with the first finger and the thumb like so. Now we're going to have various angles so that you can really understand the grip. If I was to hold my hand like so, another measuring point, okay, would be my wrist line. And you can take a close-up of this so that you're aware. We all have a wrist line. Now, as a general rule of thumb, okay, when I hold the drumstick down, it's not lower than that wrist line. So it's not in a position where the drumstick would be held back like so. That's just another rule of thumb. You'll also notice that on most drumsticks, this happens to be a Regal Tip Jazz, that in most instances the name or the trademark is at about the point where you should be holding the drumstick. And that's exactly the way it applies. All of my fingers, including my pinky. And as I started watching different drummers play and learned to understand about bounce and rebound, a lot of times in watching drummers play, I would see that their fingers would be extended outward. And the one drummer that I noticed who had a very natural grip was Buddy Rich. Anytime he played, everything was like very smooth and the fingers were never down. And basically, he never used his pinky. The pinky was tucked up underneath the drumstick, or sometimes he would use it in a grasp, but when any time he wanted to play something fast, the pinky was never really on the drumstick. And so I used that traditional grip. And we're going to give you several different views of how this right hand moves and the freedom that the stick has within the right hand. All right, this is the right hand grip that I have, and I want to spend some time on this simply because just recently, having spoken to some drummers that have looked at my previous tapes, still really didn't understand the right grip and the grasp that I used in playing. So I'm just going to make some right hand strokes and will allow you to watch how my fingers are and how the hand moves. Now you'll notice that the motion is really from the wrist. And when I start, when I play, the wrist is usually in a horizontal level plane, okay, with my whole forearm. In other words, my wrist isn't bent up initially when I play. I start at a level position and I play down rather than starting up and working down. So the motion is a waving. That's the way the wrist moves. And it's not, if I was to look at the wrist from the side, it's not bent up, it's not bent down, it's really a level extension, straight extension, not bent out of the way. Okay, so this is the motion that the wrist makes. Now, with the drumstick, it's still making the same motion. The fingers allow movement of the stick. So depending upon the stroke, even if I'm making long stroke, there's still freedom. The stick is never grasping, it's never clutching, it's never like a stranglehold tight. There's always movement. And if you at any point were to try to remove the stick, it would easily come out of my hand. So it's not a tight grasping motion. Okay? Now, at some time in playing faster, even though the wrist is making the motion, the fingers come into play. Now, all of this depends upon the volume of the stroke, the how loud or how fast that you're playing. Smaller, more petite, lighter strokes are controlled more from the fingers. When you want more power, that comes from, if you want more volume, that comes from power, so it becomes more of a wrist stroke. So like your wrist makes a motion, but your fingers can also make a motion. This is wrist. The wrist is making a snap, and even though the stick is loose and the fingers are adhering to the drumstick, the power from here is in the wrist. Now the wrist is moving, but as I get a little bit faster, the fingers can actually control the rebound or the bounce. That's the fingers controlling the rebound.